Hi learners, welcome to this course. So in this lecture we are going to see installation of VMware workstation in Windows. This is for all the first year students, those who joined engineering for the first time, or anyone who wanted to use Linux operating system in their existing Windows laptop or Windows machine. That's all. So we have host operating system and we have guest operating system. So host operating system, for example, Windows, that the machine what you are, the laptop with Windows. So that's what we call as the host operating system. Your laptop with Windows, your laptop with Windows. So that's what we call host. So guest means one who come and stay there. So that's what the guest. So we are going to use Ubuntu 18.04 version. So in this we are going to install this. So without bothering or without partitioning your hard disk or without partitioning anything, so you can able to install this Linux OS into Windows. So what are the things you need? So you need, number one is RAM is 8 GB, my storage is 480 GB SSD. So SSD means solid state drive. So I converted solid state drive. So this is my 480 GB. So that's what my, so among this 480 GB, 2 GB to be allocated to Ubuntu virtual machine or virtual OS, we can say. Okay, so that's 2 GB I want to allocate. And how many processors you want to allocate? So I have Core i5 processor. I want to have Core i5. So in that case, see, because what happens is both the operating system will be running parallelly. So 2 GB, if it is allocated, then your Windows will be having only 6 GB. Similarly, Core i5 is, I'll just give you, so you can see how many processor you can see here. The number of processors only one. So in case I want to give two processor, I can give it. Okay, so it means Windows will be having only two. So let me go with one directly. And we have another option here, virtualize Intel and virtualize CPU performance counters, all this stuff. So by default, for time being, we'll just don't use these stuffs and close it. So I'll give only one processor for, how many processor? I'll give only one processor for Ubuntu. So one processor for Ubuntu I have given, and storage is 20 GB. So you can increase later point of time. You can increase it later stage also. You can increase these values later too. So no issues. So we can do that now. Go for installation, then finish. So once it is finished, you can see here waiting for connection. Then now it's starting. So the OS is booting for the first time. And it is asking for any tools to be VMware tools for Linux. Now we have to install it and we'll just download it. By the timing it will download also. So this is for enabling full screen mode for this guest operating system. So Windows, you know, it is working in full screen, but the Ubuntu, the guest operating system will be given only a little amount of the display. So if you want to make a full-fledged display for the guest OS and other permissions also, so in that case you have to use the native tools. That's why we call VMware tools. If you don't use VMware tools, then whatever the host is telling, the guest has to do accordingly. But in this case, the VMware may give some hardware rendering, hardware increased performance, all this stuff it will give you. Okay. So now Ubuntu is getting installed now. So now verifying the installation configuration. It's installing now. Still we need to set the username, password, other steps. So only for first time installation it takes more time, because we are given only one processor and 2 GB of RAM. So maybe later point of time when you open this operating system, it will be fast. So now some guidelines I'll just give you. Recommended settings for installing VM means virtual machine. So at least have 8 GB RAM. If your machine have 4 GB, then allocate 1 GB for Ubuntu. So core i5 at least allocate one CPU at least to Ubuntu. Number 3 is storage. Storage will not be an issue for you, so give them 30 GB. Recommended 20 GB. So these are the 3 things that you can think of. Okay, so now it is getting installed on the thing. After installation, you will get this screen. So I'll just show you how it is happening. Yeah, back fronts. So now you can see that I have just logged in it, and you can see this is the way that I got installed this Ubuntu operating system inside the Windows virtual machine. So now you can see the window is very small enough. So we have to install the VMware tools which already installed. So what we can do is we can close the shut down the virtual client. So we'll shut down the guest. So once we shut down, we'll get the front screen like we have opened. Just I'll show you that. So you can see now VMware. This is a workstation. I double clicked it. So you can see now here we have got Ubuntu 18.04_64-bit. So you just click play virtual machine here. So after the installation got over, we have got this screen. So once you play virtual machine, now the system is trying to boot. Since we have only 2 GB RAM, it may be taking some time to get booted up, but only for the first couple of times it will be slow, but after that the booting time will be very fast. Also, you need not shut down every time, so you can simply put hibernate or you can simply pause the client, pause the guest. So even you can send a control alt del to virtual machine. This is Intel full screen mode. Enter full screen mode, we can use it. And in the player, we can go and see the settings here. You can see this is a virtual machine settings. So in these settings, you can check what we have done earlier. So 2 GB RAM we have allocated, one processor, 20 GB hard disk. The CD drive also will be auto detected. Network adapter is network address translation. So how the internet gets worked in the guest machine is, the host machine will share the internet to the guest machine. So that means whatever internet you have in your Windows machine will be applicable for your Ubuntu also. So the suppose in case if you don't want NAT, then you can have host only, custom and LAN segment. So there are so many options available. So by default you keep it as NAT. By default you keep it as NAT. So now we have got it. Now login inside. So you can type the password. So we got the screen. So now what I do is I'll just use the full screen mode, entering the full screen mode. Yeah, so we got it. So maybe first couple of time it will be slow, but so now just see when I use the full screen mode, so automatically the operating system will be coming in full screen. Just check it here. Maybe the rendering is taking some time, so maybe I'll just set the settings over there. Manage virtual settings. So in the options here, general is given here and power. So enter full screen mode after powering on. So you can directly give this here in case if you want to do that. And between host to guest, you can always share the files and folders between this. So just add a folder. So let me add a folder. So what is the host path? The host path means, let's say I want to add anything in the download folder, I want to share it to Linux. So in that case, I will simply use downloads. The name is downloads. Next. If you want to have in read only option, you can use read only, or if you want to copy paste from either way, you can do that. Finish. So this we can do. And that's it. So now, okay. So now what happens here? So we got the full screen. Even if you click this hide command, so you can get to know that this is the installation of Ubuntu operating system within Windows. And you can check the terminal. Open terminal. So in the terminal, you can check the size of the hard disk. So the size of the hard disk is somewhere around 14 GB is remaining. So 5.6 GB is already installed for the operating system. Remaining 14 GB is remaining. Okay. Now we can check the RAM and other steps also. So the first command you can do is sudo apt update. This is the first command that you can put and enter the password. The password will not be revealed. See, I didn't configure any internet by directly the internet gets connected because of this network address translation NAT. So whatever your host machine have the internet, the same internet will be applicable for the guest machine also. So this way you can simply use your Linux operating system. Even if you do not want to partition your machine, you can use this option. So that's the thing. So in this machine, you can download the ContigiNG operating system as we have seen here. So you can download the ContigiNG software. So we'll see this in a next video. Thanks for listening. So please update your comments in the discussion forum of our course, so that I will just look after whether you succeed or not. Those who already use Linux operating system in a separate Linux machine, so they can start proceeding to install the ContigiNG software. Thank you.